Right, well, moving on, for most people, the day they get their keys to their first home is cause for huge celebration. But for a growing number of Aussies, scammers are shattering their dreams and robbing them blind.
It's the next frontier in Australia's battle with online scammers. Their latest target, Aussie home buyers. Criminals raking in millions, stealing our hard-earned home deposits and settlements.
Millions of dollars in a transaction are available if the attacker gets it right, so they're highly incentivised.
Here's how it works. Scammers impersonate solicitors, conveyancers or PEXA, Australia's clearinghouse for property settlements, sending emails or text messages to home buyers just 2 or 3 days before settlement. Then they trick them into misdirecting their money to criminal mule accounts before whisking that money away into overseas accounts.
PEXA scams are costing over $1 million a year. It's millions and expected to grow.
How do they know who to target? Well, lax data protection from real estate agents, lawyers and property conveyancers makes it pretty easy.
Some attacks compromise the legitimate users of PEXA, so the conveyancers, to trick them into revealing their passwords and then logging in as the conveyancer and making behind-the-scenes changes.
And with more than 150,000 mule accounts across Australia last year, it's clear scammers have been busy. PEXA, not so much. Its assurances as far back as 2018 that it was beefing up security, not enough. But it's not just PEXA that's to blame.
Everyone's involved in this. It's a complex thing that goes wrong in a complex way. We should be thinking, who's able to fix this? Who's able to stop it happening? And there it's clearly the banks and PEXA themselves.
Meanwhile, customers like first home buyers Jessica Greentree and Will Clinton are left picking up the tab. After replying to an email, apparently from their solicitor, the Sydney couple transferred their near $50,000 deposit to a mule account. They lost the lot. Now, as their wedding day approaches, Jessica and Will's dream of starting a new life in a place of their own, for now, remains out of reach.
Well, Jessica and Will are with us now. Guys, this is obviously such a devastating thing to have happened to you. How hard was it to put the money together in the first place?
Yeah, it was incredibly difficult. Jess and I were both, you know, working our full-time jobs. I was running my own business, trying to get extra income where I could. Jess actually started selling firewood as well, and pretty much would save, you know, most of our wages and just, you know, spend very little at the shops. We would have a set budget, and if we couldn't afford it, we'd have to put it back. So save so much, you know, money just trying to be frugal as possible.
We stopped going out. If we did go to a cafe, we'd share a meal together. Yeah. Share one coffee. But yeah, that's how we saved.
Having put that much effort in to get that money together, what was the feeling like when you realised that it was gone?
It was devastating. Will had contacted me while I was at work. I just went into tears. And it was just devastating that a year and a half worth of savings just gone in an instance.
It felt like we'd done so much for nothing, and it was just gut-wrenching.
Probably the worst day of our life.
When you received the email from your lawyer, were there any red flags in that at all?
No, there actually wasn't. Like, when we received that email, the whole timeline, all the details, they all matched up, and that's where, you know, we thought everything was legit because they had all our details, the correct price, the correct address, and the timeline. Yeah, like I said, it all linked up, so it was... And the email address as well had the letterhead down the bottom. It had everything.
It was quite well written as well. And we had actually been to the solicitor the day before, and I'd asked about when we'd be paying the deposit, and he said we'd be in contact about that. And then it was the next day that we received that email, so we thought, you know, everything lined up perfectly.
It's so awful. You know, a house sale is such a complex transaction. There are so many sophisticated people involved in it, lawyers, real estate agents, bankers. You know, have any of these people along the way taken any responsibility for what's happened?
No, unfortunately not. You know, we're the victims of the cybercrime, and they're saying that we authorised the transaction, but no one in their right mind would authorise a transaction, you know, to somebody that is posing to be someone else. So it's just incredibly frustrating, and trying to get anybody to, you know, talk to or help, but without them just pigeon shoving the blame, it's just impossible.
and NAB were the ones that allowed for this mule account to be opened. And, you know, if this didn't happen, then, you know, we probably wouldn't have been scammed. So NAB hasn't put their hand up and taken any blame.
Well, you bank with Macquarie. Did they offer any money as a result of what happened?
Our bank, when we spoke to our bank, they didn't offer us anything until we went through AFCA, and then they offered us a goodwill payment of $500 for our $48,000 loss. So we just thought that was disgusting. Just couldn't even fathom that as a, you know, a response to our, you know, issue.
So you guys, you lost all this money. Did you also lose your house?
No, we didn't. So we were lucky enough to be able to still purchase the home, but we have had to put renters in just to be able to afford the mortgage now, because after being scammed, we were left with nothing.
We were lucky to be able to drop the deposit amount from 10% to 5%. So that was able to pretty much use every cent we had and then basically just get it over the line. But we haven't been able to move into it, which is what our goal was to do.
What's your message to other Australians that are in the process of purchasing? Obviously, a lot of this took you totally by surprise.
Just do as much as you can in person, because you really don't know who you're talking to behind a screen.
Jess, we'll really appreciate you chatting to us tonight. Good luck with the wedding.
Thank you.
So unfair, isn't it? Statements from PEXA, NAB and Macquarie Bank are available on our website.